Hey guys, it's Jay here from jvapes.com, and today I want to make a really short video to basically just explain the differences between a clearomizer, a cartomizer, and an atomizer, because I know when I first started, I was really confused about this, and I'm still getting a lot of newer vapers asking me questions on my channel about this. So today I'm going to explain what all these things are in plain English. So first let's start with the cartomizers. So cartomizers usually come in like a 5-pack like this. They usually cost about 5 to 10 bucks. And basically cartomizers are a sort of a long metal tube thing with poly-fil right through it and a wick and a heating coil at the bottom. And the way that we use these cartomizers is like this. First, we remove the little plastic bit out of the end of the cartomizer, and then we just fill up our cartomizer with e-juice. Now, there are a few different ways that you can fill up your cartomizers and that people like to do it, but the way that I like to do it is to just take one of these plastic caps off the side and then fill that plastic cap up with juice, and I slowly push the cartomizer down into the plastic tubing. Then I leave it there for a few moments and then slowly lift it back up, and then my cartomizer is full. Then I can just put the plastic tip back in, or I can attach one of my own mouthpieces, and then I attach the cartomizer to a battery like this one that I've got right here, and then I can just vape it like this. Cartomizers are a super easy and affordable way to start vaping. And because they're so cheap, many people treat them as disposables. So once their cartomizer starts to taste a bit funky, they just throw it out and buy a new one. Personally, I'm not such a fan of the cartomizer. I know a lot of people swear by them and love them. I just find them a little bit fiddly. You have to refill them a little bit too often for my liking, and I find that I get a better taste off other devices, which brings me to clearomizers. Now, clearomizers are my favorite way to vape. Clearomizers are tanks that have a wick and an atomizer inside of them, and to use them, we just fill them up with our juice, and then we screw them onto a battery and we vape. Here's a look at me vaping a clearomizer. Now, unlike the cartomizer, the clearomizer can hold a lot more juice. Tanks usually range from about 1.5 mils to about 3 mils in capacity. So usually when I fill up one of these, it's gonna last me for hours and hours. And then when I do eventually run out, refilling them is super simple. I just take off the bottom, I fill it up with e-juice again, and then screw on the battery and I'm good to go. Clearomizers are a bit more expensive than cartomizers, but for me, they are the way to go. I personally find that the juice tastes better. I like not having to refill them as often. I find they leak less, and I find them just less fuss, less maintenance, and easier to use. And for this reason, 90% of the time when I'm vaping clearomizers. However, if you're looking for something a bit more advanced than both the cartomizer and the clearomizer, then maybe what you're looking for is the atomizer. Now, although technically all e-cigarettes have some kind of atomizer in them, a lot of the time when you hear people in the vaping community referring to an atomizer, or an atty for short, what they'll actually be referring to is this, which is a dripping atomizer. And this is completely different again from both the cartomizers and the clearomizers. Now, unlike the cartomizers and the clearomizers, this can only hold a few drops. So you don't just fill it up and you're good to go for a few hours. You have to actually drop it as you're vaping it. Now, personally, I'm not much of a dripping atomizer guy. As I said before, I like low fuss things. I don't want to have to carry around juice at the same time. I don't want to have to constantly re-drip. It's just not for me. However, there's a lot of people out there that love dripping atomizers and sort of class it as the purest way to vape. With a dripping atomizer, you do generally get a stronger throat hit, more vapor reduction, and a cleaner taste. And they're also great if you want to try a whole range of flavors. Once you fill up a Clearomizer, you're kind of stuck with that flavor until you run out. With a dripping atomizer though, you can try a few drops at a time of all sorts of different flavors. So if you're looking for something a bit more advanced, then this could be for you. So I know that that might all still be kind of confusing if you're new to vaping. Which one should you get? Well, if you're looking for something that's really low maintenance and low fuss, but that still tastes great, go with the Clearomizer. Cartomizers are awesome if you're looking for something that's dirt, cheap, and disposable. Or if you're a purist and you like to change your flavors regularly, then go with the dripping atomizer. Now, if you want some recommendations on what type of cartomizers or clearomizers or dripping tanks to get, then you can click here to head to my blog post where I put together a list of my favorite devices along with the cheapest places to get them. And as always, don't forget that you can click here to subscribe for more vaping guides and reviews in the future. Stay cool and vape on.